are born into a powerful lion dynasty known as the Kakanika Pride. As the young heirs, Tao and Banda benefit from their father's protection and the bounty of their kingdom. But they won't inherit this realm. At 2 years old, they are banished as outcasts and leave the Pride Lands forever. And so begins their coming of age, their trial as nomadic males. On the fringes of society, they must learn a new set of rules. Actions have life or death consequences. Tested to the limit as they mature, their strength is their blood bond. Will they survive this rite of passage and win a kingdom of their own? This is the Lion Brotherhood. Buffalo, a formidable adversary. Vast herds spill over the Kakanika Pride Lands. Their grassy smell pervades Tao and Banda's childhood. These are the giants they must slay one day. A moving barricade they will learn to hunt. This is where the brothers will hone their skills. Prime real estate in the middle of the Okavango Delta in Botswana. Their territory is a patchwork of brown and green. Pride lands that include swamps with permanent water. So buffalo rarely leave their area. Tao and Banda will learn from the best, because Kakanika lions are expert buffalo killers. The bellow summons the cubs like a dinner bell. The females are hunting. At 10 months, Tao and Banda are old enough to join the mothers, with instructions to watch and learn. But the brothers aren't the only ones who respond to the cries. Buffaloes have a kinship as tight as the lion's bond. They protect their own. This meal bites back. A buffalo is 5 times the weight of a lioness. A well-placed thrust could cripple a lion for life. On the sidelines, the brothers are out of danger and out of the way. But when they try to help, they distract the females, and the buffaloes get away. But just as quickly, the brothers see how misfortune turns into opportunity. The stampede exposes a loner, and the lionesses react. Mothers are fearless, driven to control and conquer. So Tao attempts his first jump on, risk-free. On the rump, he's away from immediate danger. Banda feels safer behind a tree. His practical will come later. When they get the buffalo down, Tao helps at the sharp end. His instinct to strangle is appropriate, but he lacks the strength. When reinforcements arrive, he realizes he's in over his head. Better let the experts do this. It takes the combined bite force of two adults to finally squeeze the life out of the buffalo. With a buffalo dead, horns and hooves are no longer a danger. It's what Banda's been waiting for. And then, more good fortune. A reed buck in the wrong place at the wrong time. The pride females make it look easy. In an instant, there's an appetizer on the menu. More than enough for everyone. The brothers are accustomed to this endless supply of food. While Banda gorges himself, Tao takes the opportunity to practice his suffocation technique. The antelope's head is the size he can manage. He clamps its nose and mouth shut to block off access to air. It's how he'll kill buffaloes one day. But for now, he leaves that to his elders. Food is the mother's responsibility. Their fathers handle security. The Kakanaka males spend time away from the family patrolling their borders. This area of the Okavango Delta is full of pride lands, seven in total. Each one as large as Paris. And other lions have their eyes on the Kakanaka territory. The pride males continually scent mark the perimeter of their territory as a warning to keep out or face an attack. But warnings don't always work. Today, the smell of the family's carcass tempts nomads into the heart of their territory. Though Tao and Banda hardly notice, the mothers are defensive, but they'll wait for the males to make the first move. The nomadic females may get a chance to eat, but the juvenile male won't be tolerated. And then the young brothers see firsthand how their fathers, the pride males, deal with rival intruders. The trespasser is lucky to escape with his life. Roaring is their final act of dominance. A bulletin to neighboring prides. It communicates location, prowess, and ownership. With their fathers on guard duty, Tao and Banda enjoy a meal in peace. On hunting trips with the lionesses, the brothers experience all the quirks of Delta living. Wet and chilly paws come with the territory. Although today, Tao learns how to stay dry. It looks easy when his mum does it. Bingo. Cautious Banda gets cold feet. No matter the obstacle, the lionesses stay focused on their primary target, buffaloes, sometimes going to extreme lengths to keep track of the herd. These grazers account for 70% of the prize food, so it makes sense to keep them in their sights. As the buffalo crisscross Gakanaka, the lions follow, and Tao and Banda learn about their world. The forest reveals an alternative prey source. Tao and Banda have eaten impala before, but not often. These agile antelope usually outrun the lionesses, and the meager food reward is not worth the effort of a chase. This herd seems too alert for an ambush, and they've got help. Impalas and baboons share sentry duty. Eyes and ears primed at multiple locations and levels ensure top-notch surveillance. Though no one sees Tao creep closer. Until now. With the alarm raised, the lion's game is up. They won't catch an impala now they've been spotted. Now 18 months old, Tao and Banda's focus is hunting. And they pick up the subtleties of stalking buffalo by watching the lionesses. They control the pace of the hunt, understand that measured calm must balance the energy of an ambush. They hang back on purpose and study the herd for weak spots. Perfect. A straggler, and he's injured. They move into attack positions. Lionesses and cubs are now a single unit. Their adrenaline-fueled onslaught catches the bull off guard. And the support of the cubs gives the lions a weight advantage. Within seconds, they wrestle him down. Both brothers are now experienced enough to help on the kill. Banda stops the bull from kicking the rest of the pride. Tao smothers his cries before the herd can attempt a rescue mission. With so many females around, they both practice without pressure. And when it gets too hard, there's always a mother to take over and deliver the suffocation bite. But this idyllic childhood doesn't last. 6 months later, carefree days and easy meals end abruptly. The attack comes without warning. It's a brutal pride takeover. The rival's timing is perfect. He's waited for this moment for weeks. He storms into their territory when the family is separated and scatters the remaining females. Only one Kakanaka male is close enough to retaliate. But the rival's intense power is overwhelming. When their father bolts, the brothers know they're conquered. They surrender their pride lands forever. Tao and Banda flee for their lives. It's a jolt to adulthood, as extreme as night and day. Yesterday, the brothers walked with a pride as usual. Today, they are alone. Quite naturally, they stumble onto the first rule of survival as nomadic males. Stick together. A coalition is their best chance to win a territory one day. And a mate. This play session recalls their time together as cubs. And that's vital. Their bond is their insurance policy for the future. The brothers wisely keep a low profile and move through different territories quickly without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. A 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Tao dives right in, but Banda's wary. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Banda gets over his worry and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life.
This show was created for you and your family to watch together. Welcome to Nat Geo Wild.
After 6 months, the prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop their calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for them to hunt. But how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. predator tracking is the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory, that roar is their cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival: stay away from territorial pride males. Tau breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. Tau's been spotted, and now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Tau is on his own. Banda's nowhere to be seen. The pride male's age gives him confidence. But Tau ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tau doesn't back down. Pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tau narrowly escapes. External scars heal quickly. Internal ones take a lot longer. Tau's impulsiveness puts them both in danger. Banda probably wouldn't survive alone. Rainstorm brings healing and relief to the land and the lions. Now 3 years old, they've stretched into broader versions of themselves, though they still play like cubs. As the storm breaks, a month of pent-up energy is released. It's a chance to exercise stiff muscles. And reaffirm their blood bond. Their spirits remain undampened. The year moves on, and Tau and Banda's bodies change again. Light manes turn chocolate-colored. Their strategy remains the same. They skirt round the edges of territories, alert for food or danger. So the brothers fan out to recce the area. Banda heads for the thicket. He has to be careful. And so far, prudence has served him well. There it is again. And then he catches a whiff that confirms his suspicion. Fresh meat. Only this carcass is taken. Females do occasionally tolerate nomads on their kills. And Banda's subservience gains him access. But good manners won't fill his empty belly. And now he's big enough to pull rank. The females don't run far. His bluster is more hunger than malice. But this time, valor trumps discretion. Tao also notices an intriguing smell. But it's not a carcass. She is. The beauty with the collar. Her scent is intoxicating. It pulls him on an invisible leash. Banda and food are forgotten. A new hunger drives him. She has his undivided attention. But he has to wait till she allows him to approach. They cross half a dozen floodplains. They could be anywhere. Tao's not aware of anything but her. The sun is low when he catches up to her. Too close, not yet. That's not Banda's roar. And he didn't imagine it. That's a pride male, the beauty's consort, less than a kilometer away. His roar sends a clear message of ownership. Her spell is broken. Tao's not prepared to go through that pain again. He doesn't think about direction, He's just got to put as much distance as possible between himself and that roar. Hours pass, and Tao is still retracing his steps. The swamps look different at night. He doesn't know where Banda is. He doesn't know where he is. He needs Banda to find him. He's never seen this tree, but he marks it to tell Banda he was here. His roar carries for 5 kilometers. Why no answer? Is Banda coming? Tao recognizes something. He's definitely been here before. Or has he? It's risky calling non-stop. It's not only Banda out there. But it's more dangerous to be alone. Tao is exhausted, but sleep doesn't come. Still nothing. Where is Banda? Sound of hope. Banda. He has come. His relief is unmistakable. Back across the swamp, but this time together. Banda knows the way. A year later, and their transformation is complete. As 4-year-old lions, Tao and Banda boast full dark manes, the hallmark of maturity at last. When Tao picks up the scent of a female, he now has the strength to fight a pride male for her. But he's not rushing into anything. Banda's also eager to mate, though the brothers won't fight for the right. Coalition males follow a strict policy of first come, first served. The females' calls persuade the brothers to act. She's alone. She's ready to mate, and she's nearby. It's all the encouragement Tao needs. He wants to be first. He makes it clear to Banda that he's won the honor. A gentleman's agreement between brothers. Banda will wait his turn. Tao savors her scent and tests her readiness. Markers in her urine confirm she's in heat. But then something different hits his nose. The pride male. Their female belongs to him. There's no way to avoid a battle. And now it's a pride takeover. The lioness is too precious to lose. Tao reacts on instinct. But Banda's being strategic. One-on-one, Tao and the pride male are evenly matched. Teamwork tips the balance for the brothers. When the pride male submits, Banda immediately targets their asset. The pride male is Tao's responsibility. Their coalition is the game changer, a united front in the battle for territory. The pride male will be banished, and the female found. The brothers' time has come. By morning, Banda's first to reach her, and he wins the title of consort. Though he won't do anything but wait. It's the lioness that'll initiate the mating act. This is one time in lion society where the fairer sex calls the shots. It will happen in her time, when she's ready. Tao is a little worse for wear after the fight and the long chase, but undamaged. He's on guard duty. He'll only mate when Banda allows him to. As brothers, their bloodline would endure no matter who sires the cubs. They carry the same genetic code. It's the key benefit of brotherhood. Over 2 days, Banda's resigned persistence makes an impression. Before the female trusts her fate to the brothers, she has to be sure of their long-term commitment. She's choosing her cubs' fathers after all. When they finally mate, it's with the familiar comfort of an established partnership. Now their course is set, and a period of hectic activity will replace Banda's time in limbo. The lioness stays in estrus for 5 days. So she'll try to mate 3 times an hour, every hour through the night, until Banda's had enough. Repeated coupling is her best chance to fall pregnant. And then it's Tau's turn. The brothers get equal opportunities to mate, and therefore to claim paternity. They switch roles without a fight. Although after waiting 2 days, Tau's a lot more impatient than Banda. He claims this ultimate prize. So hard won, but now truly deserved. He announces their new status to the entire neighborhood. The new kids on the block are here to stay. Their lioness is not the only female to join them. She has 2 sisters who also consent to mate. In less than a year, Tau and Banda lead a pride of 11. No longer in exile and forgotten, but pride males, vital to the fabric of lion society. Cubs inject new life into the brothers and give purpose to everything they do. They are now the role models to guide their sons and daughters. With help from the females, they assume their rightful place as the family's protectors and providers. Because of their unbreakable bond as brothers and a stranger willing to take a chance. Tau and Banda beat the odds to secure a legacy and perpetuate their bloodline like their fathers before them.
Tell me what you think. So close now, just
and they pick up the subtleties of stalking buffalo by watching the lionesses. They control the pace of the hunt, understand that measured calm must balance the energy of an ambush. They hang back on purpose and study the herd for weak spots. Perfect. A straggler, and he's injured. They move into attack positions. Lionesses and cubs are now a single unit. Their adrenaline-fueled onslaught catches the bull off guard. And the support of the cubs gives the lions a weight advantage. Within seconds, they wrestle him down. Both brothers are now experienced enough to help on the kill. Bander stops the bull from kicking the rest of the pride. Tao smothers his cries before the herd can attempt a rescue mission. With so many females around, they both practice without pressure. And when it gets too hard, there's always a mother to take over and deliver the suffocation bite. But this idyllic childhood doesn't last. 6 months later, carefree days and easy meals end abruptly. The attack comes without warning. It's a brutal pride takeover. The rival's timing is perfect. He's waited for this moment for weeks. He storms into their territory when the family is separated and scatters the remaining females. Only one Kakanaka male is close enough to retaliate. But the rival's intense power is overwhelming. When their father bolts, the brothers know they're conquered. They surrender their pride lands forever. Tao and Banda flee for their lives. It's a jolt to adulthood, as extreme as night and day. Yesterday, the brothers walked with a pride as usual. Today, they are alone. Quite naturally, they stumble onto the first rule of survival as nomadic males. Stick together. A coalition is their best chance to win a territory one day. And a mate. This play session recalls their time together as cubs. And that's vital. Their bond is their insurance policy for the future. The brothers wisely keep a low profile and move through different territories quickly without being spotted. But others can't help attracting attention. It's worth investigating. They haven't eaten in 4 days. All the signs look promising. And as they get closer, a familiar stench confirms the find. 7-day-old carcass is hard to miss. Tao dives right in, but Banda's wary. And it's difficult to get enthusiastic about a mouthful of maggots. Rotten meat is not dangerous to lions, because their stomachs secrete digestive enzymes powerful enough to deal with a heavy bacterial load. A vulture can handle the mother load. The original owners don't make an appearance. And Banda gets over his worry and his queasiness. This won't be the only time they'll eat leftovers. Scavenging and stealing is now their way of life.
This show was created for you and your family to watch together. Welcome to Nat Geo Wild.
After 6 months, the prospect looks hopeful for the brothers. Summer is when buffaloes drop their calves. They can take advantage of this glut of protein. They just need a strategy. He's the right size for them to hunt. But how do they set an ambush without alerting the herd? His mother's not taking any chances. Back to tracking. It's the pattern they know. Though every step takes them deeper into enemy territory. That roar is their cue to leave. And the second rule for nomadic survival. Stay away from territorial pride males. Tao breaks both rules when he suddenly splits from Banda. Curiosity doesn't end well for cats. Tao's been spotted. And now the bigger male knows he's inside his pride lands. Tao is on his own. Banda's nowhere to be seen. The pride male's age gives him confidence. But Tao ignores all the visual tip-offs of dominance. The pride male roars his final warning. Despite the threat, Tao doesn't back down. Pride male delivers the ultimate lesson in humility. And Tao narrowly escapes. External scars heal quickly. Internal ones take a lot longer. Mara's impulsiveness puts them both in danger. Banda probably wouldn't survive alone. The rainstorm brings healing and relief to the land and the lions. Now 3 years old, they've stretched into broader versions of themselves, though they still play like cubs. As the storm breaks, a month of pent-up energy is released. It's a chance to exercise stiff muscles. And reaffirm their blood bond. Playing in the rain, their spirits remain undampened. On, and Tau and Banda's bodies change again. Light manes turn chocolate-colored. Their strategy remains the same. They skirt round the edges of territories, alert for food or danger. So the brothers fan out to recce the area. Banda heads for the thicket. He has to be careful. And so far, prudence has served him well. There it is again. And then he catches a whiff that confirms his suspicion. Fresh meat. This carcass is taken. Females do occasionally tolerate nomads on their kills. And Banda's subservience gains him access. But good manners won't fill his empty belly. And now he's big enough to pull rank. The females don't run far. His bluster is more hunger than malice. But this time, valor trumps discretion. Tau also notices an intriguing smell. But it's not a carcass. There she is. The beauty with a collar. The scent is intoxicating. It pulls him on an invisible leash. Banda and food are forgotten, A new hunger drives him. She has his undivided attention. But he has to wait till she allows him to approach. They cross half a dozen floodplains. They could be anywhere. Tao's not aware of anything but her. The sun is low when he catches up to her. Not too close, not yet. That's not Banda's roar. And he didn't imagine it. That's a pride male. The beauty's consort. Less than a kilometer away. His roar sends a clear message of ownership. Her spell is broken. Tao's not prepared to go through that pain again. He doesn't think about direction. He's just got to put as much distance as possible between himself and that roar. Hours pass, and Tao is still retracing his steps. The swamps look different at night. He doesn't know where Banda is. He doesn't know where he is. He needs Banda to find him. He's never seen this tree. But he marks it to tell Banda he was here. His roar carries for 5 kilometers. Why no answer? Is Banda coming? Tao recognizes something. He's definitely been here before. Or has he? It's risky calling non-stop. It's not only Banda out there. But it's more dangerous to be alone. Tao's exhausted, but sleep doesn't come. Still nothing. Where is Banda? The sound of hope. Banda.